हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजे इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 61। वहन टेक्नोलॉजीज यूजेस आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस एंड मशीन लर्निंग एंड हैज क्रिएटेड सॉल्यूशंस फॉर एक्सरे बैगेज स्कैनिंग एंड अंडर व्हीकल स्कैनिंग सिस्टम। वहन टेक्नोलॉजीज इज इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ इंस्टॉलिंग 250 क्लोज सर्क्यूट टेलीविजन कैमरास इन द कल्याण बॉम्बेवली म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन टू इंप्रूव सर्वेलेंस एंड ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट अंडर इट्स स्मार्ट सिटी मिशन प्रोग्राम। सो फार 75 ऑफ द 250 कैमरास ऑफ द इंटेलिजेंट ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम हैव ऑलरेडी बीन सेट अप। YouTube has started rolling out a new video resolution setting for its Android and iOS applications. Until now, YouTube present a list of resolution for video playback along with an auto option, which allowed the application to automatically adjust the video quality depend upon the speed of your internet connection. But now, under the quality menu of the video, you can see the total of only 4 options: auto, higher picture quality, data saver and advanced. Auto continues to work like before, while the higher price quality settings uses more data for a better quality stream. In our experience, it capped the streaming to 720p even on a high speed Wi-Fi connection. Twitter and other social media platforms have removed about 100 posts of URLs after the government asked them to remove content that was critical of handling of the current medical crisis or spreading fake news around the pandemic. Twitter said it has notified the impacted account holders of its action taken in response to a legal request from the Indian government, while Facebook did not comment on the issue. Twitter was expected to launch a new tip jar feature for its audio-only Spaces platform. The company later confirmed the addition of the feature, but now Twitter wants to add a tip button to individual profiles as well. The new button hidden in the Twitter app suggests the feature could be just around the corner. The new tip button will be integrated with a number of popular payment portals to allow users to easily send money to others. These supported platforms include Bandcamp, PayPal, Venmo, Cash App, that Twitter could later add other payment options as well. The tip button can currently be found next to the edit profile button. Asus has confirmed that it will introduce its upcoming flagship smartphone, the Zenfone 8 series, in an online event on May 12th. It is expected to announce Zenfone 8 and 8 Pro smartphones along with a Zenfone 8 mini as per the company post, big on performance, compact in size. Lenovo held the YogaX Xeoxing Spring product launch event in China. At this conference, the company announced a number of computers and accessories. Let's look at an accessory called Lenovo ThinkPlex Sprocket Portable Omnidirectional Microphone Speaker. This product comes with a Bluetooth 5.0 to connect with any Bluetooth-enabled devices like desktop, laptop, tablet and smartphone wirelessly. It is backed by 500mAh battery that would charge via USB Type-C. It is said to offer an endurance of 4 hours, can be used plugged in as well. OnePlus Bullet's Wireless Z Base Edition getting a black color variant soon. The wireless earphone launched in India back in October 2020. They are currently available in Reverb Red and Base Blue color. Xiaomi announced its own version of foldable smartphone, the Mi Mix Fold, almost a month ago, and of course, question about the durability of the moving parts will arise, as it usually case with the foldable smartphone. To prove the rigidness of Mi Mix Fold, Xiaomi put its vigorous testing. The device withstood more than 400,000 bendings, which roughly translates about 10 years of normal usage. One would argue that by the time, you would have other more pressing issues with the phone. The test itself was carried out in the span of 7 days and the Mi Mix Fold was violently folded non-stop during a live stream in China. Realme has set April 30 for an event in Malaysia. The event is an AIoT Grand Launch Season 3 and the manufacturer plans to announce 7 new products that includes 2 new smartwatches, earbuds and a Bluetooth speaker and many more. Realme Watch is getting a successor and it will arrive as the Realme Watch 2 ahead of its release. Images, specifications and features of the watch have been surfaced. Realme Watch 2 will have a 1.4-inch TFT color display with 320x320 resolution. The battery capacity is almost double now from 160mAh in the first gen model to 305mAh and the battery life is now up to 12 days. The Redmi K40 Game Enhanced Edition will be announced on Tuesday, April 27th in China. Ahead of the event, Redmi has officially posting details of the device on its social media channels. Today, the manufacturer has released a new teaser poster that confirms the battery capacity of the phone. It also released a promotional video that gives a good look at the device and the ambient light built across the camera housing. This phone will have a 5,065 mAh battery capacity that sure is a significant bump in the battery capacity. For a gaming phone, it makes sense that Redmi has increased the battery capacity. Previously, it confirmed that the device will come with a support for 67-watt fast charging, the fastest ever in the Redmi phone and a significant bump from the 33-watt its sibling supports. Vivo has confirmed that the launch of its latest mid-range 5G smartphone, the Vivo V21 5G in India on April 29th at 12 noon. This is the world's first smartphone that has 44-megapixel water drop front camera with optical image stabilization. That helps the user to get a higher degree of sharpness and more percentage of shots with lesser motion blur, especially at the low and medium light conditions. Spotify announced that it would be taking on Apple's brand new podcast subscription service. Unlike Apple, Spotify will not charge a fee, nor will it take a membership cut from the creators. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.